this presentation is prepared by the first author, Dong Liang Mu, from Huazhong University of Science and Technology. Unfortunately, he couldn't come here to make it due to the COVID. So I'm here to present the work on behalf of him. This is a measurement work. It investigates bug report duplication in the Linux kernel. I hope this work can do you a favor to study kernel bug reports. This is a joint work with Yue Qichen and Zheng Penglin from Penn State, Chen Shengyu from Georgia, Washington, Xin Yuxing from Northwestern University, and Gang Wang from UIUC. Without doubt, operating system kernel is very important. As it said that, civilization runs on Linux. Almost all top supercomputers run on Linux. Many data centers and transportation systems heavily use Linux kernel. The Android system, which is a Linux distro, constructs the foundation of mobile computing. Nowadays, even military weapons and the International Space Station also have Linux kernel run in their system. The Linux kernel is so security critical. However, the Linux kernel is buggy. In the past decade, we've observed many attacks launched against the kernel using the internal vulnerabilities. For example, bad webs, dirty core, dirty pep, and many attacks demonstrated in .1. As the kernel runs as a high privilege, once it's compromised, attackers can take control of the whole system and steal sensitive data. To secure the Linux kernel, the community has developed many tools to detect kernel bugs. Among all the tools, the most successful one is Syzkaller. It is developed by Google and is able to find 200 bugs per month in 12 months. It can discover bugs not only in the core kernel, but also in subsystems like USB drivers. When triggering a bug in kernel, Syzkaller will produce a crash report like this. You can get lots of information from the crash report. It includes bug title, which consists of error type and the name of function where error happens. In the example on the slide, the error type is user free and the function is print utility of in a file system. You can also find the call trace from the crash report, which records the control flow context at the triggering time. Syzkaller is so successful that in the past 3 years, it produced over 10 million crash reports. As Syzkaller is a continuous fuzzing tool, it inevitably will repeat triggering the same bug. Therefore, the majority of produced reports are duplicate, which means they are produced by triggering the same bug. To deal with this, Syzkaller uses a heuristic for deduplication. It groups crash reports by bug title. In other words, as long as two crash reports share the same bug title, Syzkaller considers them as triggering the same bug. On slide, we have a list of crash reports produced at a different time, simply because they have the same bug title. A user free in the same function. All the crash reports are grouped together. Obviously, you can imagine the heuristic is inaccurate and problematic. On the right side of the slide, we use a concrete example to explain the problem. In the example, we have three bug titles. They actually refer to the same bug based on our analysis. Using bug title heuristic, they are mistakenly classified into three groups since they are associated with different functions. The maintainer A takes care of the out-of-bound write in RMD function, and the maintainer B is responsible for the out-of-bound write in SSA function. Since multiple maintainers work on the same bug, it causes redundant manual efforts. As a result, other bugs may lack of enough manpower to analyze. To make things worse, every maintainer has a limited view of the bug behavior. Therefore, the patch developer in individual maintainer may be very specific to the reported bug title. When the crash in the TGR function is not fixed, it results in incomplete patch, which implies security risks. To fully understand the problem of bug report duplication and design solutions, in this work, we seek to answer the following questions. First of all, how prevalent is bug report duplication? Secondly, what are the potential costs of duplication? Third, what caused the report duplication? And finally, how to effectively deduplicate bug reports? To answer the first three questions, we conduct a large-scale measurement of duplicated bug reports in the Linux kernel. Based on our measurement results and discovery, we propose new strategies to deduplicate kernel reports. Our evaluation shows that our strategies are effective in the real world. First thing first, for measurement, we need to establish a ground truth set. In this set, all crash reports belong to the same bug are correctly grouped. To build a ground truth set, our insight is Syzkaller will mark the fixed commit in the crash report for every fixed bug. This fixed commit refers to the patch that can remediate the reported class. Therefore, we treat reports sharing the same fixed commit ID as the same bug and build the ground truth set. In total, we collect reports from over 10,000 bug titles that are fixed in a certain time window. Among these bug titles, we discover that over 1,000 bug titles include duplicate bug reports. From these bug titles, we sampled over 300 bug titles for manual analysis. As the analysis requires high level of expertise in kernel security, we built a very professional team of 5 security analysts. All of them have in-depth knowledge of the kernel. They also have first-hand experience in bug analysis and exploitation. We further got IRB approval for the analysis. It took us over 2,000 man hours in total. On average, every kernel bug took 8 hours to complete the whole analysis procedure. The whole procedure includes 6 steps. We start from reading reports and reproducing bugs. Then, we test the effectiveness of the patch and diagnose the root cause. If the patch doesn't work, we exclude them from further investigation. Through diagnosing the root cause, we can learn whether 2 bugs refer to the same bug. Finally, we compare the behavior of bug reports and conclude the causing factors of duplication. As you can imagine, we heavily use tools like QMU and GDB for analysis. QMU is for bug reproduction, and GDB is for root cause diagnosis. Through analysis, we discovered that bug report duplication is very prevalent. More specifically, around 47% bug reports are duplicated with other reports. Recall that we divide bug reports into groups according to the fixed commit ID. The bug reports share the same fixed commit are associated with the same bug. We observe that 14% of bug groups include more than 5 bug titles, indicating that these bug titles are not correctly grouped. We further observe that the largest bug group contains 45 unique bug titles. We investigate the cost of bug report duplication. We observe that duplicate bugs have longer open time. This means to fix bugs that have duplicate reports, more discussion are involved, which causes redundant manual efforts. As a result, it delays the patching of duplicate bugs. As you can see in the middle diagram on the slide, around 20% of bug groups have an extra delay for more than 50 days. Besides, we also observe that more manpower is needed for patching bugs with duplicate reports. We took one more step to study the causing factor of report duplication, and we identified 6 major factors. Due to the time limit, we will only cover 3 major factors in this talk. You can refer our paper to learn more. The first factor is different inputs. As you can see in the example on the slide, when the arguments of key control system call are different, the kernel will execute different program paths. After triggering the bug root cause, different input will result in cross in different kernel functions. This makes this caller produce reports with different bug titles, though they are indeed caused by the same bug. Factor one occupies more than 40% of all the situations. The second factor is thread interleaving. In the example on the slide, we have two threads. After freeing the PS state object in thread A, the kernel will schedule thread B for execution. Depending on what function is going to be executed, user free happens in different functions, either in this function or in this function. This factor takes over around 14% of all the situations. The third factor is memory dynamic. The example on the slide shows the situation where the buffer index goes far beyond of the boundary and access an unknown error. If the region is a red zone, Syzkaller produces a report with auto bound as the error tab. If the region is in free, the reported error tab is user free. As such, the two reports are duplicated, though the bug titles are different. Around 14% situations fall in this factor. So far, through a large-scale manual analysis, we will answer the first three questions. In the following, I will elaborate on how we design new strategies for deduplication based on our analysis and show the evaluation results. Due to the time limit, I will only cover two strategies. For the first factor, we calculate the similarity of two proof concept programs using Levenstein distance. We treat two reports as duplicate if the distance is smaller than a threshold. Otherwise, they are not duplicate. For memory dynamics, the goal of our strategy is to reduce the randomization of memory layout. More specifically, we further enhance the memory quarantine mechanism by keeping freed slots in allocator queue for a longer time. Besides, we replace slab allocator with slab allocator not only because slab allocator has a larger red zone, but also it prioritizes the allocation of slots at the beginning of the page. In this way, we have a higher chance to catch the ground truth behavior of the triggered bug. We evaluate the strategies for deduplication. Our evaluation data set has over 700 duplicated pairs and more than 70,000 non-duplicated pairs. The baseline is a popular stack similarity algorithm from cluster fuzz. We don't use Syzkaller strategy as baseline because obviously our strategy overperforms Syzkaller. This result shows that in general, our strategy has higher true positive rate and lower false positive rate. The performance breakdown, as you can see on the right side of the slide, demonstrates that the false positive mainly come from the first factor, input difference. The reason is because the performance of our strategy for the first factor relies on the empirical choice of the threshold. These evaluation results confirm the effectiveness of our strategies. We applied them to real-world open bugs to catch previously unknown duplication. We identified 27 groups of duplicate bugs from 455 bug reports. We manually analyzed these groups and found out there is no false positive. We reported our results to the community and received recognition from them. To sum up, we conducted a large-scale measurement about bug report duplication. We discovered that first, bug report duplication is prevalent based on our measurement results. Second, duplication costs extra manual efforts and time. Besides, we identified six factors of bug duplication. Correspondingly, we proposed six new strategies for deduplication, and they work well both in evaluation and the real world. Finally, thanks very much for attending my talk. Feel free to contact us by email, and I'm very happy to take questions now. Thank you. Yeah.